Hi, and welcome to the plugin autopsy of FXAA, which is our latest free plugin from Plugin Everything. So, what is FXAA? To describe what FXAA is, let's start with the problem. And the problem is, as old as computer graphics, it's aliasing. And you all know it as that ugly stair-stepping or jaggy artifact that you see in computer games or on any computer graphics, really. We don't see aliasing in real life because the vision that we see with our eyes isn't limited by pixels. When we display something on a screen, it's limited by the resolution of the screen. For example, geometry doesn't have a resolution, but when we want to display it, it is a process called rasterization, taking the unlimited resolution of the geometry and then converting that into a bunch of pixels. That's what rasterization is. That's generally where aliasing occurs, and it's most evident when you don't have enough pixels to display the geometry with. FXAA is a relatively new solution to, as I mentioned, a problem that's as old as computer graphics. There are some other methods that have been used. Each method has its own pros and cons. The most notorious of these is called supersampled anti-aliasing, or SSAA. And essentially that involves drawing the geometry at, say, double or even four times the output resolution. So once we have the super resolution final rendered image, we then scale it down to the delivery resolution, and we have to scale this down using subpixel sampling, otherwise the effect will be destroyed. And then we have our essentially anti-aliased result. The result will be much smoother than if we had just drawn it at the native resolution, but obviously this is incredibly expensive to do. If we are doubling the resolution, that's not just twice the processing power, that's four times the processing power, as well as four times the memory requirement. So incredibly expensive. It does work, but not really used much these days. There's another more modern technique called MSAA, or multi-sample anti-aliasing. And essentially what this is when we do the rasterizing, instead of just the camera sending out one virtual ray to sample some geometry and detect what color that pixel should be, multi-sample anti-aliasing, however, will send out multiple rays per pixel, usually four, and each ray is slightly offset. And then once it returns the four values of the different samples, it then blends those four together, and the average of those four is the final rendered pixel. You can, of course, do more than four samples. You can do 8 or 16. However, there is a diminishing return based on the amount of samples that you send out. This technique uses a lot less resources than supersampled anti-aliasing and has pretty good results. However, it is still quite expensive because we are sampling the geometry. And so that brings us to the topic we're talking about now, FXAA, which stands for Fast Approximate Anti-Aliasing. The difference between FXAA and the other two we talked about is FXAA is applied to the final rendered image. And so we're not sampling geometry now, we're just sampling pixels. For every pixel on the final rendered image, the GPU looks at the pixels surrounding that pixel and sort of does an edge detection algorithm. It's looking for places of very high contrast, which is the stair steps that we're trying to get rid of. When it detects a very harsh edge, it knows where that pixel is in relation to the current pixel, and so it can apply a specialized or a very intelligent blur that smooths that edge out. So you may be wondering, what's the difference between FXAA and simply just applying a 2-pixel blur to the entire image to essentially get rid of those stair steps? Well, FXAA, as mentioned before, it only applies the blur where it needs to, and it's applying a sort of an intelligent blur rather than just a blanket Gaussian blur to the whole image. And this makes it a lot more effective at removing the stair stepping, because if you have harsh aliasing, you might need to set like a 5-pixel blur, and then obviously you can't do that for the whole image because now your whole image just looks out of focus. So that's what FXAA is doing. If you'd like to learn more of the nitty gritty about FXAA, it's actually Timothy Lotz, the very intelligent man who came up with FXAA, has posted the entire process and the instructions on how to do it online for free, and he's made it widely available. And thanks to that, you'll probably see FXAA in every modern computer game, just because it is so much faster and so effective at fighting aliasing. It's almost removed the need for any other kind of anti-aliasing. That's how effective it is. What we've done when porting it to After Effects is taken that initial algorithm, but we've also done an extra step. And the reason that we've done an extra step is because in After Effects, we're often dealing with layers that have transparency. FXAA initially isn't designed to work with transparency because what you see when you're playing a video game is a buffer of pixels or the final rendered result. It doesn't have transparency. You don't see the Windows logo through the pixels of your game. So to work with transparency, we need to know the color of the pixel behind the layer that you're working on. But what if there is no layer behind there? Well, then we need to assume a color, and generally we assume that color is black. However, there might be a gradient behind your layer. There might be multiple colors. So to deal with this, we do a two-step process. The first step is we take the original layer and blur it, and that sort of just expands the edges a bit, bleeds the colors out. And then we place the original non-blurred image on top of that. Then we apply the FXAA algorithm to that. And so if you've got some white text on a gray background, now it won't have to assume that the color, the background color is black, and it won't have an ugly black fringe around the result. Now you can apply FXAA just to one layer as opposed to an adjustment layer on top of your entire composition and just blanket FXAA everything. Because although FXAA is designed to only blur areas that are edges or stair steps, you still are doing more processing by applying it to the whole layer, as well as you may be degrading the image a little bit. So this allows you much more freedom. You can apply it just to one layer or two layers, wherever you want. As well as if you want, you can just slap FXAA on the top. So certain scenarios that FXAA are useful for is if you're doing motion trails, such as with Echo or Cartoon Moblur, those are very prone to crunchy edges with all the samples stacking up on each other. Another situation where you may need FXAA is when you're dealing with super brights. For example, if you've got a layer set to the add blend mode, but you're not working in a linear 1.0 environment or color space, that add mode is probably gonna look really crunchy. I'm sure every After Effects user has experienced that. So that's a candidate for FXAA to remove those stair-stepping. If you guys know some scenarios where you've experienced jaggies, let me know in the comments, because those are the two that I can think of. So that's about it for FXAA. Make sure you check it out. It's free, so it's not gonna cost you anything. The link is in the description. We also have other free plugins such as Quick Chromatic Aberration and Text Border. Those are pretty fun as well. So yeah, they're free. You can't complain because you didn't pay for them, and don't send me a support ticket.